So after an off day yesterday, rain kind of washing everything away, Yanks back to work on the field tonight. We'll bring you that intra-squad game coming up. But news of the day is Aroldis Chapman testing positive for coronavirus. That news coming from Aaron Boone a short time ago.
Right, Bob. And in this 2020 season, every team expected to get this kind of news. We know that coronavirus looms over every sport that's trying to come back. But when it comes, even though you had been expecting it, there's still apprehension, anxiety, and tension. Aaron Hicks, one of Aroldis Chapman's teammates, talked about that, wondering how much time might you have spent with that player. But getting back to Chapman, he actually tested it positive on Thursday. The Yankees announcing it today. As soon as he tests positive, Bob, you have to look at that operations manual, or by this time the Yankees have memorized it. Immediately have to have a face covering on, immediately have to self-isolate, and then you have to restrict all activities. Aroldis Chapman has to be at home right now, not moving around, not doing anything. And in order to come back, Bob, he's got to test negative twice, not have a fever for at least 3 days.
You mentioned the mask. He'll get that saliva test on a daily basis for 7 days. Again, right now it's about self-isolation, making sure he doesn't infect anybody else. As far as the mechanics of it, too, within the clubhouse, they have to begin that contact tracing to, as you said, find out exactly who spent the most time around him.
Right, and obviously this impacted some teammates and or employees. We don't know. The Yankees weren't specific about that. Manager Aaron Boone said, listen, I'm not going to get into all these specifics, but he said as far as where they are right now, no one else has tested positive. But, Bob, within that graphic that we just showed, there's a lot of things for teammates and people who had been around Chapman to think about. I thought it was interesting when Aaron Hicks said he starts going back in his mind trying to figure out, did you play catch with this person? Yep. Did you walk past this person on your way to the shower? So Chapman's loss does sting for any type of injury. But in 2020, it's a different type of injury situation, medical situation that all teams have to deal with. He now joins DJ LeMahieu and Luis Sessa, two players who tested positive before coming to New York. He tests positive now after being part of these workouts.
Yeah, he did the intake testing. He had tested negative. That's how he had to get on the field initially, but now he has tested positive. So let's talk about how it impacts the team and how it impacts him. If you figure he has to be out at least 14 days, roughly, just to restart things, season begins in 12 days.
Right. To quote Aaron Boone, he will not be at Yankee Stadium for the foreseeable future, but you're absolutely right, Bob. We can all do the math, and it doesn't look right now as if there's any way you would see Aroldis Chapman to begin the season, and the Yankees will give updates on his status. Where do they go with their closer being gone? They're fortunate that they have Zach Britton, who has closed in his career for the Baltimore Orioles. In fact, he had one of the greatest seasons that a closer has ever had. You have Ottavino and Canely at the back end of the game. Bob, I start to wonder, not that you don't miss Chapman, you absolutely miss the Cuban missile being able to come in and shut down those ninth innings. But I start wondering who are going to be the pitchers that pick up and get those outs in the fifth, sixth, and seventh inning now. You might be able to use Ottavino, Canely, and Britton to collect you 12 outs on certain days. But then there are going to be days where you need Chad Green, Loaiza, Sessa if he comes back, King, Schmidt, Garcia, Heller, Holder. Throw all those names into the mix. They're going to get a shot because the Yankees are going to need that pitching depth.
Well, when they were beset by injuries last year, they really had that next man up philosophy. They embraced it. So many guys came through, and it leads you to believe, like tonight, for example, we're seeing Clark Schmidt again. Could he try and open more eyes to say, well, maybe normally he wouldn't have begun the season in their bullpen, but yeah, we need him now because we might be down one guy.
I think they've already started to open, Bob. I think the Yankees knew who they had in Schmidt. I think the fact that this is already the second time we're seeing Schmidt, I think the Yankees want to push a little bit. Masahiro Tanaka threw a baseball on the field today, but still dealing with having those concussion symptoms, so we don't know his status as of yet. So far, things have been positive with him. Will they need another arm in that rotation? And if they do, is someone like Schmidt a pitcher who can ascend and take that spot? Bob, I've loved what I've seen out of him from videotape that I watched of him in the minor leagues, but then also what we've seen of him at the intra-squad level. Just